assigned to you. He worked in the post office downtown. As a matter of fact, he was so dedicated, he delivered the final post that they had at home. He's very proud of that job. And, you know, I would like to be a postman. I would read all the postcards. And I would look at the postmarks and see where you're getting letters from. Of course, that might be why I've never worked with the postal service. Roscoe did enjoy that job, and he felt it was very important, but unfortunately, he was a Republican. The reason that was such a problem was because every job in Mandeville, from mayor all the way down to dog catcher, was an elected position, and postmaster right in the middle there. So one year the Democratic ticket held strong, Roscoe was out of a job. So he turned in his keys, he came home and delivered that final post, went up to his room, took off his uniform, put on his pajamas, and he did not come out of his room again for 22 years. His wife, realizing he was a bit upset about losing his job, had dinner sent up to him, and then breakfast and lunch and dinner for 22 years. When he finally passed away, they put him back in the uniform, buried him in the graveyard, and they say that that night and many nights hence, people have seen what appears to be a postman come down the street, stopping at every post office box and going in. People in room 5 or 7, they do often complain that they've left their necklace in there clasped together, and when they come back it's unclasped. Or watched, it's unhooked, and they come back it's hooked together. Nothing ever goes missing, and if you go to Elizabeth, she'll just say, "Don't worry, just Roscoe up his old tricks." Roscoe Jones had a son, his name was Ray, he lived next door. And Ray was a tugboat captain forced to retire at 55. So he came home and took off his uniform, put on his pajamas, and did not come out of his house again for 30 years. We would say to him, "Uncle Ray, are you crazy like your father?" And he would say, "I am not in my room, I'm in my house. And if the outside world has no need for me, then I have no need for it." He had these brown horse head pajamas. They were so ugly. And they were his favorites, of course, because his wife despised them. In fact, it is said that there was a letter with the will that said he wanted to be buried in those pajamas. However, as his wife found he was dead, she went over to Elizabeth City and purchased flannel suit and a tie and a shirt that matched. And of course, he was buried in that beautiful suit. And when we saw him laying there, all dressed up, we said, "My goodness, he looks good in clothes." I had never seen him in anything but pajamas. But when we cleaned out the house, we could not find those pajamas, so the rumor went round that his children, knowing how he was when he didn't get his way, had dressed him in those pajamas under that brand new suit. Now you have to realize, this is a small island, 3 miles by 17 miles, and the bridges are new. Everybody who's been here more than a generation or two is related by blood or marriage. Well, when they have a family reunion for the Jones family, it involves many, many people. And there's always somebody who's a bit depressed. And when that person is circled by the nucleus of the Jones family and they say to them, "You are Jonesin," which reminds them of Uncle Ray and Roscoe Jones, and they usually snap right out. Now this is a good place to get orb pictures, especially on the older part of the house over here. Sometimes along the attic windows, this tree gets some orbs in meet you right over here under this